Okay, so last lecture we had started with the format of cost sheet, I mean operating cost sheet, that is CAS 5 format we had done. We are doing operating sheet, this CAS 5. Now let us first understand what things we had done in that, what I had covered. So the first point I had covered was about the classification of cost under CAS 5, that was fixed cost and variable cost. Then what was the elements which were included under fixed and variable under CAS 5, and then the basis of calculation, what is the calculation base for CAS 5. Okay, so coming to that, okay, so draw a rough format. Okay, CAS 5, draw particulars column. Draw particulars column and two columns for the amount. Okay. Okay, so here it goes. Okay. Later, particulars, then this amount column, and then this column. This is very important column. Okay. So first fixed cost, under fixed cost the first one is interest on bank loan, which is taken for the vehicle. Okay. Next, garage rent. I had explained in the last lecture why all this comes under fixed cost. Then license fees or permit fees. Then we have spoken about depreciation. Okay, scubby note I had discussed with you all. Then other fixed cost category. Anything that doesn't come in point number 1, 2, 3, 4 will come in point number 5. Then the total of fixed cost. Next, the loop is variable cost. Okay. I had also discussed about Iska basis, why it is variable, because it depends on kilometers run. So in that, first is petrol. Second is depreciation. Okay. And I had discussed this, and this will depend on the basis. Either it will become fixed or variable depending on the question. Then I spoke about salary to operating staff. And then I also discussed about who comes under operating staff. Okay. The people who come under operating staff, that was also discussed by me. Who comes under operating staff? The mechanic, then the cleaner, then the driver, and the conductor. Any other staff other than these four, if they are receiving salary, then it will come under other fixed cost. Otherwise, it is a variable cost. Okay. Next, I spoke about depreciation is done, this is done. Then I spoke about repairs and maintenance. Repairs and maintenance. Then we were supposed to add this. I will get my total variable cost. Then I was supposed to get my total cost. Then add profit to this. And lastly, I will get my sales. Okay. So this is what we had done. Again, the same thing, but we are discussing it right now. Okay. And yes, the heading which you want to give is, I'm talking about the heading. This heading will be operating cost sheet. Operating cost sheet for a month or for a year. This will depend on the question. Operating cost sheet for a month or for a year. So that will depend on the question. Okay. So is this clear to everyone till here? Okay. Yeah. Shreya is asking me, ma'am, you had also said about the other variable cost. Yeah, dear. I have also spoken about the other variable cost. Yeah. That will be also a part of the, what do you call this? Okay, fine. I will add it here. Just add here, fifth one, other variable cost. Okay. So there are five elements up, five elements down. Okay, thank you, Shreya. Five elements up, five elements down under variable cost. Okay. Yeah. Now, let us come to this third part, which is most important, because your whole question depends on this. Okay. So, this part will depend on your cost unit. Okay. And question paper may, they will mention whether it's a simple cost unit or it's a composite cost unit. It will be mentioned, matlab aapko khud hi read karke identify karna hai. Question mein itna directly nahi diya rahega ki calculate the cost as per composite unit or calculate the cost as per single cost unit or simple cost unit. The question will be not that specific. Okay, you have to read and analyze whether it is simple cost unit or a composite constant. Okay, so since we are doing transport, since we are doing transport cost sheet under CAS 5, so simple cost unit will indicate cost per kilometer. Okay, क्योंकि क्वेश्चन में आपको बोला है कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट पर किलोमीटर और कैलकुलेट रेवेन्यू पर किलोमीटर. सो हियर द एलिमेंट इज वन, देयर इज ओनली वन एलिमेंट व्हिच इज देयर, इट इज दिस पर किलोमीटर, ओनली वन एलिमेंट इज देयर. सो दिस इज सिंपल. एंड इफ द सेम क्वेश्चन टेल्स यू, सेम क्वेश्चन टेल्स यू टू कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट पर टन किलोमीटर्स, ये सब लास्ट लेक्चर में एक्सप्लेन किया था, बट अब मैं थर्ड कॉलम समझा रही हूँ इसलिए आई एम रीडूइंग इट अगेन. और इफ दे आस्क यू टू कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट पर पैसेंजर किलोमीटर, ओके, सो हियर यू हैव टू एलिमेंट्स, सी टन्स भी एंड किलोमीटर्स भी, सो दिस इज कॉम्पोजिट. हियर ऑल्सो यू हैव टू एलिमेंट्स, पैसेंजर and kilometer, two elements, passenger भी kilometer भी, okay? तो ये रहा. तो सबसे पहले आप question paper में क्या देखोगे, आप question paper में पहले ये देखोगे कि whether you have been asked to calculate a simple cost unit or a composite cost unit, okay? And how will you come to know from the question? If they tell you to calculate cost per kilometer, so it is simple cost unit. If they tell you to calculate cost per ton kilometers or cost per passenger kilometer, it is called as composite cost unit. Okay, so accordingly the formula will change. Now you understood, everybody understood the basis of calculation. Basis samajh mein aaya sabko? Please acknowledge in the chat box. Everyone has understood till here, because understanding basis is important, then only you will understand the formula which I am going to frame now. Okay, so I've got acknowledgement from the student. Yeah, thank you. Now coming to the formula, okay? So, pehle, students, just see what I am writing the formula and then analyze what changes I am making in the formula, okay? So, coming to okay. सो सबसे पहले आप क्या देखोगे, जैसे मैंने बताया, आप सबसे पहले देखने वाले हो कि आपका कॉस्ट यूनिट क्या है पेपर में, बराबर. फिर उसके हिसाब से आप वर्किंग नोट करोगे, बराबर. नाउ लेट अस राइट द वर्किंग नोट. सो स्टूडेंट्स प्लीज डू राइट द वर्किंग नोट अलोंग विद मी, ओके. सो वर्किंग नोट, वर्किंग नोट इज नथिंग बट कैलकुलेशन ऑफ फॉर्मूलाज, okay. So the first working note you are going to do is calculation of running kilometers, because aapka cost is pe hi depend karta hai, aapke jo bhi cost hai wo is pe hi depend karte hain, kilometers run pe. Anything जो running kilometers पे depend करेगा will be a variable cost. If any expense is not depending on this calculation, then it is a fixed cost. That is why the what do you call the calculation which is a must, which is mandatory for all the sums of transport cost sheet is this calculation of running kilometers. So how do we calculate this running kilometers is important. Obviously, हम running kilometers कैसे calculate करेंगे? पहला, आई विल सी एज अ ट्रांसपोर्टर हाउ मेनी व्हीकल्स आई हैव. सो द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट इज नंबर ऑफ व्हीकल्स, ओके. नेक्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू सी वेदर माय व्हीकल इज गोइंग टू टेक हाउ मेनी ट्रिप्स इन अ डे. सो नेक्स्ट कैलकुलेशन एलिमेंट विल बी नंबर ऑफ ट्रिप्स, ओके. Next, I'm going to see number of ways. I'll explain this concept, number of ways, okay. Next, I'm going to consider kilometers run. गाड़ी कितना किलोमीटर दौड़ रही है, कितना किलोमीटर चल रही है. And then I will calculate depending on the question again. Agar mera cost sheet, now see, my cost sheet, if my cost sheet is monthly or my cost sheet is yearly, okay, iske upar depend karega. So the next calculation element which I'm going to consider is number of days in a month or in a year, depending on the question. Okay, number of days in a month or in a year, this will be specified in the question. So if I consider all these things, it is called as running kilometers. Okay, so this concept from year till year is known as running kilometers. Am I clear to everyone? Anybody has a doubt with respect to this? Okay, now the next important thing is, what is this number of trips and number of pace? Okay, now let me make you all understand this. ये क्या होता है, ठीक है? ओके, चलो तो देखते हैं क्या होता है ये नंबर ऑफ ट्रिप्स, ये नंबर ऑफ वेज का क्या कैलकुलेशन है. ओके, नाउ से दिस इज व्हाट यू कॉल टाउन ए. फ्रॉम टाउन ए आई एम गोइंग टू टाउन बी. From town A, I am going to town B. Now, town A से लेके town B तक मेरा रास्ता है 100 किलोमीटर का. बराबर, मतलब गाड़ी 100 किलोमीटर चलेगी town A से लेके town B तक. Okay? तो इसको बोलते हैं ये one way. Yeah, this is called one way. ठीक है? अब गाड़ी अगर वापस आई, ओके, अब ए से बी पे गई है तो बी से वापस ए पे भी तो आएगी. ओके, तो गाड़ी वापस आए करे तो वापस 100 किलोमीटर कवर किया, मतलब दोनों मिला के 200 किलोमीटर गाड़ी चली. ठीक है, सो इसको भी वन वे बोलते हैं. ठीक है, तो 1+1 इज व्हाट, टू वे. Okay, so when I say two way, it means I have completed one round trip. So one round trip is equal to a two way journey. समझ में आया? Yeah. So one round trip मतलब गाड़ी जाके वापस भी आएगी, same दिन, याद रखना, गाड़ी जाएगी भी और वापस भी आएगी. Okay, तो हम क्या करते हैं, सारे कैलकुलेशंस को डबल नहीं करते हैं, हम सिर्फ जो राउंड ट्रिप है उसको डबल करते हैं, तो बाकी के सारे कैलकुलेशंस ऑटोमेटिकली डबल हो जाते हैं. जैसे किलोमीटर्स रन, आई विल नॉट से किलोमीटर्स रन इज 200, आई विल से इट इज 100 ओनली, बट आई मल्टीप्लाई इट विद 2 बिकॉज द इट इज अ राउंड ट्रिप, इट विल गो एंड इट विल कम बैक, तो आई विल से 100 इनटू 2, तो ऑटोमेटिकली इट बिकम्स 200. So I don't have to say 100 kilometers plus 100 kilometers 200. No, the logic behind calculating 200 kilometers will be 100 multiplied by 2 way. So that will automatically become 200 kilometers. Am I clear to everyone? So unless and until question paper mein it is not mentioned ki it is a round trip, we will not assume it to be a round trip. Okay, we will assume ki it is a one way journey. You are going and you are not coming back. That's it. Okay, but if it is mentioned ki you are going and you are coming back, you are going to and fro, you are returning, there is a return journey, so it is but by default understood ki it is a round trip. Am I clear? Okay, so this is the concept of a round trip. Any doubts till here, anyone? Just acknowledge in the chat box any doubts anybody has. It is clear to everyone. Okay. Clear? So this is how running kilometers is calculated. और इसमें important यही है जो मैंने highlight किया है, number of trips important है and number of ways important है. ठीक है, अब तुम बोलोगे मैम number of trips कितना है, number of trip तो एक ही है, एक है but एक round trip है, तो 1 × 2 जाओगे और वापस आओगे तो 2 way हो गया journey. ठीक है, like this. Okay, so this is the formula and how, what is the basis of calculating the formula running kilometers? The basis is number of vehicles into number of trips into number of ways into kilometers run into days in a month or days in a year as per the specification in the question. Clear everyone? ठीक है, तो इससे ये क्या है, ये composite unit है और हमें मैंडेटरी कैलकुलेशन करना है रनिंग किलोमीटर्स का, बिकॉज इसी पे डिपेंड करता है हमारा वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. एम आई क्लियर टू एवरीवन? रनिंग किलोमीटर्स इज द बेसिस फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ योर वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. तो जस्ट रिमेम्बर स्टूडेंट्स, क्वेश्चन पेपर में वेरिएबल कॉस्ट जनरली नहीं दिया रहेगा, वो लोग आपको सिर्फ पर किलोमीटर कॉस्ट देंगे, बाकी आपको सब कैलकुलेट करना है इस वर्किंग नोट के बेसिस पे. ओके, राइट? So now, next. So now, the next working note is working note number 2, calculation of, अगर question में पूछा है ton kilometers, तो हम ton kilometers निकालेंगे. Calculation of ton kilometers. ठीक है? तो सेम, ओके. सी क्या होगा, टन किलोमीटर्स का भी फॉर्मूला सेम है, नंबर ऑफ व्हीकल्स, नंबर ऑफ ट्रिप्स, नंबर ऑफ वेज, किलोमीटर्स रन, नंबर ऑफ डेज इन अ ईयर और अ मंथ. ओके, सो आई विल नॉट रिपीट द होल थिंग अगेन, वी विल नॉट वेस्ट टाइम, वी विल सेव टाइम. सो व्हाट विल आई राइट, आई विल डायरेक्टली राइट रनिंग किलोमीटर्स. ओके, आई विल नॉट रिपीट एवरीथिंग अगेन, बिकॉज एनी वेज इन वर्किंग नोट नंबर 1 वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट रनिंग किलोमीटर्स, तो वाई विल आई यू नो कॉपी पेस्ट द सेम थिंग अगेन, आई विल जस्ट कॉपी द आंसर व्हाट आई हैव गॉट फ्रॉम रनिंग किलोमीटर्स, आई विल नॉट रिपीट द होल फॉर्मूला अगेन. ओके, सो रनिंग किलोमीटर्स मल्टीप्लाइड विद, क्या कैलकुलेट करना है, व्हाट डू वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट, टन्स. ओके, सो व्हाट एम आई गोइंग टू टेक ओवर हियर, tons. Okay, so I'm going to take tons only, so multiplied with number of tons carried into percentage capacity. Okay, number of tons carried, this will be mentioned in the question, ki the truck or the vehicle is carrying what what amount of load it is carrying, so that will be mentioned, and percentage capacity is also mentioned. Ho sakta hai truck ki capacity 100% ho, but hum usko 100% load nahi kar rahe ho, truck mein 100 kgs ka saman ja sakta hai, but we are not loading it with 100 kgs, we are just loading it with 80 kgs. Okay, that means the truck is only 80% occupied. Are you understanding? Okay, fine. So whatever will be your final answer will be your ton kilometers. Okay, and here whatever will be your final answer will be kilometers. Am I clear to everyone? Now come to the next part of the question. Calculation of passenger kilometer. Calculation of passenger kilometer. Okay, so same concept beta. Again, I'm going to repeat everything again. Ye fir se pura repeat hoga. Okay, it will be repeated again. Okay, so same. Running kilometers into, now what was here, tons carried, what will be here, passengers carried, number of passengers into percentage capacity. Am I clear to everyone? Okay, then you are calculating ton kilometers, running kilometers is multiplied with ton kilometers, with tons carried. and when you are calculating passenger kilometer, you will multiply with number of passengers. Okay, so formula is not changing, only a little bit of element calculation is changing. Rest, both of these are same. Am I clear to everyone? Anybody has doubts till here? Kindly acknowledge in the chat box. Anybody has doubts till here? Or everything is clear? Okay, so nobody has doubts till here. Very good. No query? Anybody has any query? Okay, so no query. Very good. Is this clear? I repeat. So what is the first thing you are going to do in operating cost sheet? The first thing you are going to do is you are going to check in the question whether it is a cost, which type of cost unit is asked. So since we are doing transport cost sheet, so either it will be a simple cost unit or a composite cost unit. If it is a simple cost unit, they will ask you to calculate cost per kilometer. So aapko samajh jayega ki yeah, ye cost per kilometer nikalna hai. और अगर कॉम्पोजिट है तो आइदर इट विल बी टन और इट विल बी पैसेंजर किलोमीटर. ओके, एंड व्हाट विल बी द कंपलसरी वर्किंग नोट विच यू हैव टू डू? रनिंग किलोमीटर्स इज अ कंपलसरी वर्किंग नोट इन ऑल द सेंस विच यू हैव टू डू. व्हाई? बिकॉज इन ऑपरेटिंग कॉस्ट शीट योर वेरिएबल कॉस्ट डिपेंड्स ऑन रनिंग किलोमीटर्स. द बेसिस ऑफ कैलकुलेशन इज रनिंग किलोमीटर्स ओनली. ओके, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज अ मैंडेटरी working note. Okay, and it will not be given in the question. You have to calculate it, and uska calculation basis bhi maine aapko bata diya hai. The formula goes like this: number of vehicles, number of trips, number of ways. Number of trips and ways ka concept logic also have explained it to you about the round trip. Okay, kilometers run, days in a month, days in a year will depend on the question. And if it is 10 kilometers, I will not repeat the whole formula again. I will write running kilometers into tons carried into percentage capacity. And if it is passenger kilometer, I will again not repeat the whole formula. I will write running kilometers into number of passengers into percentage capacity. Okay, right? So if this is a 50, I mean, obviously you will have as per your paper pattern, you have 15 marks for one question. So out of the 15 marks, this working note carries 5 marks. So if you are, और एक चीज याद रखना, अगर आपका running kilometers wrong हो गया तो आपका पूरा variable cost wrong हो जाएगा, because आपका variable cost running kilometers पर depend करता है. तो ये पूरा part आपका wrong हो जाएगा. समझ में आया? ये wrong हो गया तो आपका total cost wrong हो जाएगा. Total cost wrong हुआ तो उसपे जो आप profit निकालोगे वो भी wrong हो जाएगा. और जो फाइनल आप रेवेन्यू कैलकुलेट करोगे सेल्स, दैट विल आल्सो बी रॉन्ग. ओके, सो अंडरस्टूड हाउ इम्पोर्टेंट इट इज टू कैलकुलेट व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ रनिंग किलोमीटर्स? या अंडरस्टूड ना? ओके, राइट. नाउ लेट अस कम टू डिस्कस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. Okay, now see the highlights of the question. Prabhu Shanti Transport Company. Okay, so this is important for me because ये मेरा transporter है. Okay, मैं किसका cost sheet बनाऊंगी? Prabhu Shanti Transporter. Clear one thing. Next. Okay, students, last 6 minutes are there, so you can start giving your attendance. And simultaneously concentrate on the question which I am discussing. Okay, start giving your attendance, but don't disturb yourself with respect to understanding of the question. Okay, because tomorrow I'm going to solve the same question. So let me discuss and let me relate to whatever I just explained you all about calculation of running kilometers, ton kilometers, and passenger kilometers. So let us relate. Okay, company operates 5 buses, so number of vehicle is 5. Am I clear? Number of vehicle 5, which are which are 50 kilometers apart. So kilometers run is 50. The sitting capacity of each bus, in one bus, 50 passengers can sit. Okay, and yeah, students, one of the students had asked me doubt last year, ki ma'am, when you say each bus has 50 passengers, so is the driver and the conductor is included in this? Obviously, it is not included in this. Okay, when I say 50 passengers, matlab 50 passengers baith sakte, driver or conductor ka seat hum isme nahi gin rahe. Understood? One of 48 ho jayega. Right? Yeah. The following particulars were obtained for from their books for the month of April 2010. So see, it's a monthly cost sheet. I told you, now all these highlights will be there in the question itself. So it is a monthly cost sheet. Okay. Next. Next highlight, let us see. Okay, particulars. Okay, particulars and amount. Okay, so now let us identify which cost is this. So, bachcha, ye aapka total cost hai. ये आपका टोटल कॉस्ट है इसमें से आपको यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई फिक्स्ड एंड वेरिएबल ओके सो नाउ स्टार्ट थिंकिंग फ्रॉम दैट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू तो फर्स्ट इज वेजेस ओके तो वेजेस ऑफ किसका बोला है इट इज ऑलरेडी मेंशन्ड वेजेस ऑफ ड्राइवर कंडक्टर एंड क्लीनर ओके तो ये तो हमने पढ़ लिया है वेजेस ऑफ ड्राइवर कंडक्टर एंड क्लीनर दिस कम्स अंडर variable cost so market it's a variable cost next salaries to office staff now I told you if anyone comes in apart from this three people if any other salary you are paying then it will go in other fixed cost so this is my fixed cost okay so this is my fixed cost okay Next, diesel and oil and other expenses. Again, that is my variable cost. It depends on kilometers run. So, CAS 5 ka format yaad karo. Okay? Yeah. Next, repairs and maintenance. Which category? Variable cost. Why? Because it depends on kilometers run. So, variable cost. Taxation and insurance. Okay? Insurance of your vehicle. Which you have hired, okay? उस vehicle का आपने insurance किया है, तो obviously it's a fixed cost. Other fixed cost category में आएगा, it's a fixed cost. It doesn't depend on kilometers run. Depreciation, it is clearly set on straight line basis. Now and see, nowhere in the question they have said कि life of the vehicle is in kilometers run. So in this question, depreciation is a fixed cost. Interest on garage, okay, rent, interest and rent on the garage, it's a fixed cost as per CAS 5. I'm again saying all the classifications are as per CAS 5. Then commissions to staff based on takings, okay, takings matlab beta sales, okay, cost sheet mein usko sales bolte hain, yahan pe hum usko revenue ya takings bolte hain. So commission is depending on your sales, so obviously it's a variable cost. Variable cost. Am I clear to everyone about this? Yeah. And next highlight of the question is passengers were carried 75% of the sitting capacity. So ye aapke running kilometers ke formula mein aayega when you calculate. All the buses matlab 5 buses we have. So all 5 ran 30 days in a month. So this is a monthly cost sheet. Days in a month is 30. Each bus makes one round trip. So, ये वो two-way journey वाला है. You are going and you are coming back. Okay? Classify the operating cost into standing charges. Standing charges means fixed cost. And running and maintenance cost means variable cost. Find out the cost per passenger kilometer. I hope you all remember. What did I say? You have to first see which cost unit it is. Okay, so this sum is of a composite cost unit. Okay, clear everyone? So tomorrow I'll be taking up the